Okay guys, we'll go to the next section, which is integration by parts. Another method to solve integration is integration by parts. Use this method if substitution method is not working anymore. Formula: integration u dv equals to uv minus v du. And the steps to do is, first, let the function as u and dv. You have to choose an expression that can be derived as u, and then you have to choose an expression that can be integrated and let it as dv. And then the second step will be prepare the u by differentiating the u and v by integrating the dv. And then the third step is plug in into the formula. Okay, let's take a look at example one. Example one, find the result of integration of x, ex, dx. Yeah, so for this one, I don't think you can use substitution method to solve it. Yeah, so we have to use integration by parts. Yeah, and then first you have to choose which one is the u and which one is the dv. I already told you that u is usually the one that can be derived, and the dv is the one that can be integrated. Yeah, so I think both of them can be both of them. What do I mean with both of them? Both of them means this one and this one. Yeah, so we have two expression right here, and it's involve multiplication. Yeah, as we know, if we have multiplication, then we cannot integrate it one by one. So we have to use another method, yeah, which is substitution or integration by parts. And I already told you that substitution is not working in this example, so we have to use integration by parts. Okay, let's let this one as u and let this one as dv. First, you have to prepare the du. So u equals to x, that means the du will be the differentiation of x, right? Differentiation of x is 1, and then don't forget to write the dx. And the second one will be the dv. Dv equals to e to the power of x dx. For the dv, you have to integrate it, so you will have the v equals to the integration of ex dx. Yeah, the integration of ex dx is e to the power of x plus c. Okay, you don't have to write the plus c right now, but we will write it later after we have the final answer. Next is to plug in into the formula. The formula is uv minus integration v du. So the formula is u is x, and then the v is e to the power of x minus integration of the v is e to the power of x, and then times the du. Du is 1 dx. Let's remove the 1, so I will only have the dx. Next is e x times x minus, for this one you can integrate it manually, yeah, because it's already simple enough to integrate it directly, so we can find the solution like e to the power of x and then plus c. Yeah, okay, so we already done. The final answer will be x times e to the power of x minus e to the power of x plus c. Okay, so that is how you use integration by parts. How about the second example? For the second example, let's take this one as u and that one as dv. Yeah, so the u equals to x, and then du equals to the differentiation of x, 1 dx. And then for the dv, we have dv equals to ln x dx. That means if we want to find the v, you have to integrate it, integrate the ln x dx. Unfortunately, we cannot integrate the dv for these questions. Yeah, so if you cannot integrate it, just leave it like that. Next step will be plug in all of them into the formula uv minus integration of v du. Okay, for this example questions, I want to rewrite the questions like this because I think later we will need it. Yeah. So x ln x dx equals to u times v. U times v. U times v is x times the integration of ln x minus integration, and then for the v is integration ln x dx. Yeah, so in these questions I want to show you that when you choose the wrong expression as u and the dv, you will get the complicated expression. Yeah, more complicated expression than the questions. So if you found the expression become more complicated, that means you choose the wrong permisalan. Yeah, so you have to erase all of them and then let the u, the ln x as the u, and the dv is x dx. Yeah, hopefully we can have a simpler expression for this this time. Yeah, so u equals to ln x, that means du, the differentiation of u, is 1 over x dx, and then for the dv we have x ln x, x dx I mean. And then the v will be the integration of x dx, and that means x square over 2 plus c. Yeah, so we will leave it like that and then plug in into the formula integration v times du. This time we will have u ln x times the v, x square over 2 minus integration of v is x square over 2 times the du. Du is 1 over x dx. See, we can simplify the expression like this: x square times ln x over 2, and then minus integration of half x dx. Yeah, cross out the x. So you can integrate this one easily using the normal method. Yeah, x square over 2 plus c, and the final answer will be x square ln x over 2 minus 1 over 4 x square plus c. Okay, that is for example question 2. The next one is Tanzalin method. Tanzalin method is the same with the integration by parts, but it's a quick version of the integration by parts. Yeah, so we can say that this one is cara cepat. It's a little bit hard to explain how to use Tanzalin method, so I will explain it later in the example questions. Take a look at these example questions. So for example 1, we have to find the result of integration of x e to the power of x dx. Yeah, so the condition that you can use Tanzalin method is one of the expressions, when you differentiate it, it have to be disappears at some point. Yeah, jadi kita harus pilih u nya yang di differentiate itu harus hilang nantinya. Ya, jadi kita harus pintar-pintar pilih u nya guys. So if you choose this one as u and this one as the dv, when we integrate the u, it will not disappears. Even you integrate, you differentiate it a lot. Yeah, so that will be the wrong expression to let. So I will choose this one as u and this one is the dv. So the thing is, the u have to be disappeared at some point when you differentiate it. Yeah. So as you can see, x, when you differentiate it, it will become 1. And then when you differentiate it for the second time, it will become 0. Or you can say it disappeared. Yeah. Nah, jadi biasanya yang di differentiate itu harus jadi 0. And then for the dv, when you integrate it, for the u, you have to differentiate it. For this one, you have to differentiate it. And then for the dv, you have to integrate it. Just like the integration by parts. Yeah. So for the dv, if you integrate it for the first time, you will have e to the power of x. And then if you integrate it one more time, you will have e to the power of x also. And then you will stop right here. Yeah, we will stop integrating when the differentiation become 0. And next is the answer. The answer for Tansalin method is like this. Yeah, so x times with e to the power of x. And then for this one, 1 times with e to the power of x. But for the first multiplication, the sign will be positive, and for the second multiplication, you will put negative in front of it. Okay, so for the first one, you will have e to the power of x times x, and then for the second multiplication, you will have negative 1 times e to the power of x, and then plus c. There you go. This is how you do the Tansalin method. And as you can see, our solution is the same with the integration by part example 1. Yeah, it's the same thing because the question is the same. That means the answer must be the same too. Okay, how about the second one? For the second one, I don't think we can... can we? Oh yeah, we can choose this one as the u, but it will be wise if you choose this one as the u because it will be shorter. Yeah. So this one, when I differentiate it for the first time, I will have 2x. I differentiate it for the second time, I will have 2. And then if I differentiate it for the third time, it will disappear. Yeah. And then for the dv, sorry, this one is not v, this one is the dv. For the dv, if I integrate it, I will have x plus 1 to the power of 4 over 4, right? And then if I integrate it for the second time, I will have x plus 1 to the power of 5 over 4 times 5. Yeah, because we already have 4 from the first integration. And then for the third integration, you will have x plus 1 to the power of 6 over 4 times 5 times 6. Okay. So what is the answer? The answer will be this times this, and then this times this, and the next one will be this one. For the first one, the sign will be positive, the second one will be negative, and the third one will be positive again. So the answer will be 2x, sorry, we'll start from the first one, yeah, x squared plus 5 times with x plus 1 to the power of 4 over 4. And then for the second one, negative 2x times x plus 1 to the power of 5 over 4 times 5 equals to 20. And then for the third one, it will be 2 times x plus 1 to the power of 6 over 120, and then plus c. Yeah. So this is the final answer. And of course, you can simplify like this if you want. Yeah, but yeah, just simplify it. Yeah. 10, this one is 60. Okay, this one is the final answer for example 2. Okay, the next one is volume of a region under a curve and also between a curve when the curve is rotated 360 degree to the x-axis or the y-axis. So if you rotate some curve, you can get a three-dimensional shapes which the volume can be calculated using integration. Yeah, so let's take a look at the following illustrations. So for the first one, I have this curve, or I can say it's a line, yeah, y equals to a. When I rotate the curve, the line to the x-axis as far as 360 degree, you will have three-dimensional shapes. Yeah, can you guess what shapes can we get from the illustrations? Yeah, it's a cylinder. Yeah, so if you rotate a line along with the x-axis, you will get a cylinder. How about the second one? The second one, we have fx. If we rotated it to the x-axis as far as 360 degree, you will have a shapes like this. Yeah, or you can say it's a flower face or something else. Yeah. And to find the volume, you can use this formula: volume equals to pi integration lower limit and then upper limit of fx squared dx. Yeah, so the formula is similar with the area, but you will have to put the pi in front of the integration and then you have to square the function. Yeah, please don't forget that. Next one is this one. volume between two curves. Yeah, if you have two curves, one at the top and one at the bottom, you can rotate it also to the x-axis and then you will have these shapes, yeah, with empty space inside it. Okay, it's like so if this one is solid, yeah, this one is kosong dalamnya ya. So there will be empty space ya, atau ya bolong sampai bawah. Itu biasanya dipakai untuk ngitung bahan, volume bahan yang diperlukan untuk bikin vas bunga misalnya ya. Jadi yang diperluin itu bahannya aja ya, bagian kosongnya nggak dihitung guys. Nah itu bisa pakai formula ini. You can use volume equals to pi integration of AB and then fx square minus dx square. So the idea is the same with the area. You have to minus the top curve with the bottom curve. For a curve rotated to the y axis, it's the same with the area, just change the fx into fy. Example 1, find the volume bound by curve y equals to x square minus 9, line x equals to 2, line x equals to negative 2, and the curve is rotated to x-axis. Okay. So to solve these problems, you have to sketch the shapes, of course. Yeah. So to sketch it, I already teach you how to sketch a curve and also a line in the previous lesson. So this time I will not explain it to you again. So I will draw it directly. You will have a curve like this, and then this one is negative 9, yeah. And also you have to draw the x equals to 2. X equals to 2 is right here. And then x equals to negative 2. This one will act as the lower limit and the upper limit, yeah. That means your shading will be this one, right? When you rotate to the x-axis, you will have a shapes like this. Nah, it's like apa ya itu ya? Kayak oval tapi bukan ya, ujungnya lancip, guys. And to find the volume, you have to use the formula of the volume. Volume equals to pi. Don't forget the pi because rotate itu ada pi-nya ya pasti, karena luas lingkaran juga ada pi-nya. Jadi setiap ada perputaran itu pasti berhubungan sama pi. Pi, and then the lower limit will be negative 2, the upper limit will be 2, and then the function is x square minus 9. Don't forget to square it first, and then you can find the volume. So for the volume, we cannot integrate this directly, so you have to square it first. You'll have x to the power of 4, cepet-cepeting ya. And then you will have negative 18x squared. And then for the last one, you will have 81. And then the x and then you can integrate it like x to the power of 5, right? X to the power of 5 over 5 minus 18x to the power of 3 over 3 plus 81x, and then you can find the volume by substituting the 2 and negative 2 like usual. Okay, 2 first, 2 to the power of 5, 32 over 5 minus 18 divided by 3, it will be 6, 6 times 8, and then plus 81 times 2. For this one you will have negative 32 over 5, and then negative 6 times negative 8, and then for the last part will be plus 81 times negative 2. Okay, I will calculate it for you, and the answer is 240.8. So the volume will be 240.8 pi cube units. Okay, so that is how to find the volume, yeah, if the curve is rotated 360 degrees along with the x-axis. How about the second one? Find the volume bounded by the curve this and that one, yeah. So this one we have to draw it first like usual, sketch a little bit y and x. For this one you will have, I think it's negative 2, yeah, negative 2 for the first one, negative 2 and also 4, negative 60, yeah, and also 4. Negative means like this, and then the line will be 6, this one is 8, right? This one is 6, 3, yeah, negative 2. Okay, the line will be like that. So the area will be this one, and when you rotate it along to the x-axis, you will have these shapes. Okay, and then like that. Ya, bentuknya kayak apa tuh ya? Kayak half circle, no, kayak tumpeng ya, tumpeng tapi dalamnya kosong guys ya. Ya apalah itu. Nah, to find the volume, because this time the volume is bounded by two curve, that means we have to minus the curve, yeah. So pi integration. Oh, we don't have the upper limit. Yeah, we have to find the upper limit first by intersecting them. Yeah, so y equals to negative x square plus 2x plus 8, and then we have y equals to 3x plus 6. Intersect means substitution, ya. Yeah. So you will write 3x plus 6. Ya, yeah. Plug in the y. 3x plus 6 equals to negative x square plus 2x plus 8. And then move all of them to the left side. X square plus x minus 2 equals to 0. And then factorize it. You'll have x plus 2, x minus 1, x equals to negative 2, x equals to 1. So this one equal to 1, yeah. Okay, now to find the volume you will have to use the formula pi integration. The lower limit is negative 2, the upper limit is 1, and then the top function, the upper function is negative x square plus 2x plus 8, don't forget to square it, and then minus the lower function is 3x plus 6, and then square it, and then dx. There you go. But for this time, I don't want to solve this because it will be hard to square this one. Yeah, so I will leave it like that. I don't think I will give you these questions later in the test, so don't worry about it. I will not give you the hard calculation for the test, yeah. So I just want to show you that this is how you find the volume if you have a volume bounded by two curve, yeah. Okay, so So this is the lesson for today. Thank you for watching. We'll meet again in my next video.